Hi, today I'd like to tell you about my lab's work in the field of cancer biology, and more specifically on how bacteria that reside within cancer tumors can influence disease treatment. But before I dive into that, let me give you some context. Personalized medicine, the tailoring of treatment to each individual patient, has transformed oncology in recent years. This breakthrough was achieved thanks to the genomic revolution of the early 2000s that allowed clinicians to understand that no two cancer tumors are created alike. Tumors in individual patients may look the same, but can actually be very different from the genomic level. Therefore, each individual tumor requires an individualized and personalized treatment. Since the early 2000s, oncology has become very much obsessed with chasing down the factors that makes tumors so different from one another. We now know that the microbiome is a key factor that differentiates tumors. So what is the microbiome? You might have heard of the microbiome in the context of our digestive system, our guts, where the microbiome helps break down some of the foods we consume. And it has a big impact on our overall health. Actually, the microbiome is a collective term we use to describe all bacteria, fungi, and viruses that live in every surface, nook, and crevice in our bodies. In fact, we now know that there are so many bacteria in the microbiome that they actually outnumber the number of human cells in our body. My own lab is fascinated with the tumor microbiome, bacteria that colonize within cancer tumor. Although we have known for over 150 years that bacteria can actually infect tumors, we are only now realizing how common this phenomena is. In fact, thanks to modern genomic sequencing technologies, we now know that about 50% of tumors have their own microbiome. And of course, the fundamental questions scientists are now asking themselves is how does the tumor microbiome impact disease itself? We now suspect that at least in some cases, tumors can become drug resistant by harboring a microbiome that can break down chemotherapies. Think about that for a second. The tumor resists therapy not because cancer cells themselves become immune, but because the cancer cells provide a safe harbor for bacteria. These secret passengers, in turn, can degrade chemotherapy and protect the neighboring tumor. In my own research, we are investigating how bacteria grow when they are hiding inside tumors, and more specifically, how they deal with all these nasty poisons we throw at tumors to slow down tumor growth. One of our recent studies uncovered that bacteria within tumors actually suffer from chemotherapy. Seeing that, we were immediately concerned due to another remarkable aspect of bacterial biology: their ability to quickly evolve and adapt to changes in their own environment. We therefore decided to ask, can bacteria adapt and become chemotherapy resistant? And even more importantly, will this resistance influence neighboring cancering cells? We put this theory into test by examining bacteria that frequently infect pancreatic tumors. We repeatedly exposed these bacteria to chemotherapy and tested their drug resistance. Our experiment revealed that resistance can actually emerge very rapidly, within just a few cycles of drug exposure. But our biggest surprise was that in many cases, bacterial resistance also influenced neighboring cancer cells. In some cases, bacteria became super degraders and could therefore protect not only themselves, but also neighboring cancer cells. In other cases, the opposite happens. Bacteria became resistant by pumping out the drug. In these cases, there is more chemotherapy to go around, and the neighboring cancer cells became more drug sensitive. While these are very preliminary results, we believe they illuminate a critical field that is highly underexplored: the ability of the tumor microbiome to evolve and change over time. We now believe that our observations are only the tip of the iceberg, and that bacterial adaptation to chemotherapy is actually commonplace. If this is true, there is a real need to deeply investigate the microbiome as an ever-changing entity that can influence whether chemotherapy works or not. In other words, we need to understand how bacteria adapt to their life as secret passengers inside tumors to truly understand their impact on disease progression and ensure that cancer treatments are even more successful in the future.